Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. It's 6 o'clock, so time for us to stand and say the Angelus together. The angel of the Lord brought tidings to Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
And the world was made fresh. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Pray for us, the Holy Mother of God. Let us pray, or for to receive, dear Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ thy Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion on the cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
It was not you who chose me, says the Lord, but I who chose you and appointed you to go out and bear fruit, fruit that will last. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, it's wonderful to welcome you all here this evening for this celebration. We are missing one person, Canon Dondini, I think is having trouble with traffic on the A30, so we'll forgive him. But welcome to all. We begin, as always, by acknowledging our faults, our failures, the things we've failed to do in our lives for the Lord, the things he expected of us, and the times we've let him down. And so let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous faults. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
A reading from the prophet. prophet Jeremiah. The word of the Lord came to me, saying, Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you, and before you were born, I consecrated you. I appointed you as a prophet to the nations. Then I replied, Ah, Lord God, you must be aware that I am not skilled in the art of speaking. I am only a young boy. But the Lord said, Do not say, I am only a young boy. You will go to whomever I send you, and you will speak whatever I command you. Do not be afraid of them, for I am with you to deliver you, says the Lord. Then the Lord stretched forth his hand and touched my mouth. And he said to me, Behold, I have placed my words into your mouth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Shine in our hearts, in order to enlighten them with the knowledge of of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. However, we hold this treasure in earthen vessels, so that it may be clear that this immense power belongs to God and does not derive from us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
So that my joy may be in you and your joy may be complete. This is my commandment. Love one another as I have loved you. No one can have greater love than to lay down his life for his friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I shall no longer call you servants, because a servant does not know what his master is doing. I called you friends because I have revealed to you everything that I have heard from my Father. You did not choose me, rather I chose you. And I appointed you to go out and bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that the Father may give you whatever you ask him in my name. The command I give you is this: love one another. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The ordination of a priest during the liturgy, the bishop and the attending priest exchange a fraternal sign of peace with the new priest. This gesture is a sign of welcome into the priesthood in which all priests share as brothers. During my ordination to the priesthood, over 34 years ago, as I exchanged the sign of peace with my brother priests, one of them, Steve McGuinness, who had been at seminary with me, and with a nod towards the book Genesis and the letter to the Hebrews, whispered in my ear, "You are a priest forever, a priest like Melchizedek of old." This evening, we gather together to give thanks to God for the service of Father Paul as he retires from the active ministry. Of course, Father Paul's retirement does not mean he retires as a priest. He remains a priest forever, like Melchizedek of old. As he has done in the past, Father Paul will continue to celebrate the Holy Mass, and on occasions to celebrate the other sacraments. However, this evening marks a change in the rhythm and the pace of the priesthood of Father Paul. No longer will he be responsible for the care of a particular parish or faith community. I'm sure this will give Father Paul a sense of liberation, of renewal, and freedom, and allow him to deepen his love and commitment to the priesthood in a new and different way. Father Paul has served long and faithfully in a number of parishes over the years, and I know from personal experience that he has a sincere love, loyalty, and commitment to the people he's had the privilege to serve. These qualities will not disappear, will not go away when Father Paul retires from the active ministry. I am grateful to God for the years I have served with him. He has been a steadfast and loyal friend, always ready to lend his support and wisdom. And I know that Father Paul, just like Father David Anir, who's with us this evening, will be generous with his priesthood during his retirement, ready to share the gifts given to him by God all those years ago at his ordination. Father Paul has been a great advocate for the priesthood, cheerful, fulfilled, willing, and committed to his ministry. And as Father Paul prepares to retire from the active ministry, we in Cornwall prepare to welcome Father Andrew Marlborough, who was only ordained in June. So Father Paul, so to speak, will hand on the baton to Father Andrew. And we pray that Father Andrew will be as happy, committed, and loyal as Father Paul. On this special occasion, I would ask your prayers and your support for all your priests. As Catholics, we are a Eucharistic people. The Mass, the Eucharist, is the jewel in the crown of our Catholic faith. And quite simply, without priests, there is no Mass. Because of the upcoming Synod, the Church has rightly focused on the dignity, the gifts, and the talents of the laity. And hopefully the Synod will open countless opportunities for the laity to contribute richly and freely to the mission of the Universal Church. However, the Church will always need priests like Father Paul to enable the faithful to be fed and nourished by Jesus in the Mass, in the Eucharist. So, Father Paul, we wish you a happy and peaceful retirement, thanking you for your faithful mission. However, we know that the vocation given to you by God at your ordination all those years ago continues, and you will carry on faithfully serving Jesus, his church, and his people. For you are a priest forever, a priest like Melchizedek of old.
As our Gospel has reminded us of the command to love one another, humbly we pray this evening that our intentions may be guided with God's merciful love and completed with unbounded generosity.
We pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, and our Diocesan Administrator, Paul Cummings. May they be blessed with strength and perseverance to fulfill the tasks given to them. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all priests, particularly for those who have served and those who continue to serve our parish, that they may receive the blessings of wisdom, well-being, and peace in their priestly ministry. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for Father Paul Andrew, who has kept our parish connected to each other and to the Holy Spirit by his faithful ministry to the communities of St. Michael's in Mullion and St. Mary's in Helston. We ask that he be blessed with the gift of health. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for the needs of our parish during this time of change for both ministers and faithful. May we together build a church that responds to the needs of our local community with love and compassion. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for those who are unable to be with us this evening. May they be blessed with grace and enfolded in love. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for the faithful departed, for the parents and family of Father Paul Andrew, and for all those we hold. hold in our memories. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pray with Mary, who trusted so willingly in God. Hail Mary,
full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Almighty Father, we thank you for choosing us to be your people and rely upon you to inspire and guide our footsteps in your great goodness and steadfast love. This we ask through the intercession of Jesus Christ, your Son, and in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please sit down, please. Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. preserve your people. Grant, by the power of this sacrifice, we pray, that their labours may constantly please you, and in your church bear that fruit which lasts forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just to give you and raise to you a hymn of glory and praise, O Lord, Father of infinite goodness. For by the word of your Son's gospel, you have brought together your church from every people, tongue, and nation, and having filled her with life by the power of your Spirit, you never cease through her to gather the whole human race into one. Manifesting the covenant of your love, she dispenses without ceasing the blessed hope of your kingdom and shines bright as a sign of your faithfulness, which in Christ Jesus our Lord you promised would last forever. And so with all the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, while with the church, as one voice, we acclaim. Broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying,
Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion.
Lord, renew your church, which is in your Son Paul by the light of the gospel. Strengthen the bond of unity between the faithful and the pastors of your people, together with Francis our Pope and the whole order of bishops, that in a world torn by strife, your people may shine forth as a prophetic sign of unity and concord.
Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the apostles and martyrs, with St. Michael the Archangel, patron of Cornwall and its town of Helston, St. Paul the Apostle, and all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you, through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days,
that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your
spirit. Let us offer one another a sign of peace.
Thank you.
sacrifice we have offered and received, O Lord. Give new life to your priests and to all your servants, that united to you in unfailing love, they may receive the grace of giving worthy service to your majesty. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I don't want to say very much, except to say thank you to all of you for coming. A very big thank you to those who prepared our barbecue that we're going to enjoy. Please do go down the path after this Mass and find yourselves a seat in the garden. I think it's still fine, and the food will be there at the barbecue, and there's salads and puddings and sweets, I'm sure, in the hall. My thanks to my fellow clergy for supporting me this evening, to those who have read and taken a collection and brought up gifts and done any sort of service. We're very grateful. Thanks to Michael at the organ. Thanks to Father Paul and to his chauffeur for bringing him and for their contribution. And if I've left anybody out, which is always a danger to something like that, then my thanks to you as well. I should have remembered you, and I'm sorry. Would you please bow your heads for God's blessing? The Lord be with you. Bow your heads for God's blessing. May Almighty God bless you in his kindness and pour out saving wisdom upon you.
Amen.
May he nourish you always with the teachings of the faith and make you persevere in holy deeds.
Amen.
May he turn your steps towards himself and show you the path of charity and peace.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go and proclaim the Gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In this church dedicated to Our Lady, we always end our service by singing an anthem to Mary. The one appointed for this time of year is the Salve Regina. You'll find it in the hymn books at number 367, if you don't know it by heart.
We have to dispute it. Squash it. Sorry. Well done. So nothing to do. Triumph. Then Nick.
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you for your contribution.
I'm just going to come home.